I cannot deny that I'm a big fan of Bond movies. They are my big inspiration. Those superheroes, however, are far from reality. British secret agents, such as me, are not as strong, as intelligent, and as immortal. They are just ordinary human beings. In fact, I'm more of a loser than a hero. For a long, long time, I had nothing to do. So I was wandering around the world, wasting my time, day by day, night by night. I was waiting for a call from my MI6 headquarters. Let me tell you the story of my last assignment, my mission Palermo. I was just in Prague, doing nothing as usual. Just staring at the beautiful skyline from a hotel placed in a tall TV tower. Yet another boring sunset. But then, suddenly, I received a call. My boss was calling me. My heart started beating fast. I desperately needed a new challenge. My boss was the head of British Secret Intelligence Services, and she was more of a man than a woman. In fact, I think she was more of a man than me. Never mind. She called me and she had an assignment for me. She told me I had to go to Palermo to kill the boss of the Italian mafia. I was excited. I was quite an obvious choice thanks to my Italian origin. Unfortunately, as usual, British Secret Services were short of money, and I would have to drive all the way to Palermo. I should tell you something about my boss. She was obsessed with Bond movies. She watched them over and over again. And M from the movies was her big role model. I had even the suspicion that Judi Dench was not her real name.
I'm frightened because our enemies are no longer known to us. They do not exist on a map. They're not nations. They're individuals. But look around you. Who do you fear? Can you see a face, a uniform, a flag? No. Our world is not more transparent now. It's more opaque. It's in the shadows. That's where we must do battle. So, before you declare us irrelevant, ask yourselves, how safe do you feel?
could not wait to leave Prague and get on this exciting journey. But first, I had to choose two security agents, a car, and some guns. Messenger agent Negroni came all the way to Prague to find, prepare, and introduce to me the best available security agents. Of course, he was restricted by the limited budget of British secret intelligence services. So my expectations were not very high. Finally, Negroni brought the security agents I could choose from. Girls only. One was more beautiful than another. However, was beauty really what I needed to complete my mission? I did not think so. I complained to Negroni that driving all the way to Palermo was crazy. But choosing my security from a group of six ladies just did not make any sense. Negroni did not care really, and he told me to hurry up and choose two of them so that we could depart. I looked at the candidates carefully. Each of them brought an MI6 report with their results. I started with Agent Lamborghini. She seemed a bit too short to protect me. That was why I did not pick her. She was quite upset and told me that I just made a big mistake. Agent Baldinini was quite tall, but she had very bad results. She could not shoot, she could not run. So I wondered how she could protect me. She did not hesitate a single moment. Her answer was surprising. Not interested, I replied. Agent Martini, on the contrary, had excellent results. Fast, sharp, efficient. I told her she had even better results than me. And you know what? She was sarcastic. I liked her and told her she was my first choice to join me on my mission. Agent Bellini was very sweet and assertive. She came to me and told me she could speak Italian and she knew Italy pretty well. So she was my obvious choice as well. Then we had to choose guns and a car before the journey. Martini was obsessed with guns and weapons. So I sent her to choose the guns from a secret dealer. For her, this was paradise. And not only was she a tough agent, she also had a criminal past. Robbery was her specialty. Our budget was tight. So she had to negotiate with the dealer. I can imagine how frustrated she was. Luckily, she was on duty. Otherwise, she would have killed the guy. But once she left the place and she had all the weapons with her, she was so happy. I joined Bellini to choose a car. It had to be an Italian car. We had to look as ordinary locals. Bellini worried more about the color. Apparently, it should match her shoes. So she was after all red cars, no matter what make of car it was. We agreed that the Italian car was the right choice, and she was very happy. But later I told the sales guy to give us a black version. The red would draw too much attention. The journey was long. I had to drive all the way, as my security agents were completely useless. None of them had a driving license. And they were also drinking champagne during the entire journey. I was driving fast. We had been on our way for several hours and were just passing the Italian border when the phone started ringing. Bellini was confused as usual, and she had to fix the hands-free first. Our boss, Judy Bench, was calling us. She was apparently sending Messenger Negroni with some cash. We jumped for joy. We were supposed to meet him in a small restaurant near Bolzano. We could not wait to meet Negroni. We were so happy, and just when the call finished, we made a few usual nasty jokes about our boss. Negroni was a few hours late. No wonder. He was a Cuban guy, and they are rarely on time. By the time he came, we were quite drunk. We spent our last money on champagne. Negroni brought a small box with cash. We were surprised to see it, and even more surprised when I opened the box. There was a 50 euro note. Bellini was shocked. I thought that was a bad joke. And you know what? When I asked Negroni about the situation, he found it very funny. So we were standing outside and I had to smoke a cigarette. I know I should give up. Bellini wanted to go to casino. She can apparently win some money. That was the first time I saw her interested in something else than her own makeup. Martini also agreed. Well, I realized Bellini was quite a gambler. Whatever, we needed money in order to continue. So we visited a small casino near Borders. I had hoped it would be discreet and safe. And it was totally empty. We were the only visitors, in fact. And Bellini was like a fish in the sea. I have not seen such a happy face in my entire life. She wanted to bet on her lucky numbers. 0, 0, and 7. And surprise, she was winning. And winning, and again. So just one more stop in Firenze and we would soon reach Palermo. We finally reached Florence, the romantic heart of Tuscany. Halfway through our journey, quite tired and a bit fed up after the issue with Negroni. Obviously, we needed a drink. So we ended up in the first bar that was open. My security agents just ordered their drinks when this happened. They got arrested by a bunch of gangsters. This caught them by surprise. At the same time, I was in the bathroom, finally having a moment on my own. When suddenly, someone surprised me. I felt a gun on the back of my head. For a moment, I was thinking that this was the end for me. And where the fuck was my security? The guy behind me told me I should slowly walk up the stairs and sit at the first table. No funny business. So I slowly walked up the stairs and sat at the first table. He ordered a bottle of Piccini wine, and our long conversation started. I wondered what he wanted from me. The first thing he told me was that his original mission was to kill me. But later, he apparently realized there was a family connection between us. After one bottle of wine, when I relaxed a little bit, he asked me to look at him carefully. There was a family resemblance. He told me that I was his brother. I could not believe my ears. But at the same time, I was so happy inside. No matter what family I had, the important thing was that I had one now. So I was the son of the boss of the mafia. My brother told me he would wait for me at his father's house near Palermo. So this unexpected family reunion came to an end so that we could meet again later. He took a private jet to get home fast and tell everything to his father, while me and the girls had to sit in the bloody car again and drive the rest of the journey. It was clear that I wouldn't complete my mission. But it did not bother me. I just wanted to focus on the journey. I would soon be introduced to my real Italian family. The long, long journey was about to come to an end. We were driving down the hot and dusty roads outside of Palermo. The house of my father was very well hidden from the eyes of the local and international police. Well, in fact, the police officials were certainly on his payroll. Surrounded by the olive trees and high mountains, Padrino, my father, was relaxing on one of his swimming pools. He was quite a conservative and old-fashioned guy. He liked things the old way. No novelties, no technology, no modern architecture. And for a man of his position, he was surprisingly young. His house was well guarded, As we arrived, it looked pretty humble. I expected more luxury, I guess. My brother and one of the security guards were already waiting for us upon our arrival. I got really nervous, and the dream slowly became reality. He gave me a warm Italian welcome. It felt like we had known each other for a long time. Martini was a tough girl, quite fresh, despite the long journey. She was there to protect me and stay cautious. When my brother told her not to follow us to my first family meeting with my father, she obviously was not very happy about it. But there was very little she could do. Bellini was in her own world as usual. She did not care much about what was going on. She hoped to meet a rich Italian guy and get married one day. So she simply had to be pretty. I had to make only a few steps to find out what my real father looked like. I was so nervous and excited at the same time. I did not even mind leaving my gun behind me, as my brother requested. I was sweating under the strong Italian sun. I realized how much my father was respected. He was a real boss. My brother looked up to him with admiration and hope that one day he would take his place. My brother whispered to my father that he completed his task and brought me back to the family. I was just standing there like a little boy. The first words I could hear from my father were, "So this is my second son." It was strange because, in fact, I should be his first son. But never mind, the family was finally together. I heard some footsteps behind me, and just a few seconds later, I was dead.
In the water, life feels lighter. If you swim too fast, you become a fighter.
My funeral was very private and well hidden from the eyes of the public. In fact, only my secret agents and my brother came to say goodbye to me. She explained to him that he was, in her heart, unlike me. I was an unwanted child of this family. The explanation was simple. I was my father's son, but I had a different mother. That is why Madrina Piccini, my stepmother, got rid of me and sent me to an orphanage in the north of Italy. God knows why my father agreed. And it was too late for me to find out anyway. My security guards and my brother gathered around me. Each of them stood quietly, deep in their thoughts and memories of the short history we had had together. Bellini got quite emotional. I believe she had a bit of a crush on me. Martini was rational as usual. She was thinking how to explain the death of a secret agent to the MI6 headquarters. But all of a sudden, a tall, mysterious guy appeared. He pushed my brother aside and whispered farewell words to my ear. My brother, as well as the girls, were shocked. The explanation he gave them was a big surprise. He, in fact, was my closest person, and given my past, he was my only family. My biggest secret was revealed. I believe you are wondering how come I'm telling you this story when I should be dead. Well, maybe I will tell you next time.
In the water, life feels lighter. If you swim too fast, you become a fighter. Water,
water, water
has no gravity.
Water,
water, water feels safe. Water,
water, water
gives life. Water,
water, water
is another cave. Water,
water, water
can be cold. Water,
water, water
can be salted. Water,
water, water
can be sweet. Water,
water, water
knows how to hold. Hold you without breathing when you try not to die. And you are falling deep. Water feels like you can fly. Swim, swim ahead, even if it gives you pain. Then tell your story that ground is not the same. Water,
water, water
has no gravity.
Water,
water, water feels safe. Water,
water, water
gives life. Water,
water, water
is another cave. Water,
water, water
can be cold. Water,
water, water
can be salted. Water,
water, water
can be sweet. Water,
water, water
knows how to hold. Water.